and friends of Genesis Academy and Genesis graduates. This has truly been a most interesting, most fascinating year. And COVID-19 has stolen so much from us, stolen family members, stolen time, stolen moments spent together. But we are so happy that COVID-19 did not steal this moment from our graduates. And even though they've been working very hard at home, they have been working and they earned every bit of achievement tonight. So I ask that you remain seated as I welcome Genesis Academy class of 2020. And they will be led by our principal, our vice principal, and our master teacher. Madison. Give them one more round of applause. Graduates, remain standing, and I'm going to ask the audience to stand. The national anthem will now be played. We ask that you keep your mask on and observe the instrumental of the national anthem. Seated. Graduates, you may be seated. Now I would like to invite to the stage our salutatorian, Mr. Tyler Williams, who will be doing our invocation as well as our welcome.
Please stand for prayer. Heavenly Father, we are beyond grateful for having made it to this point in our young lives. Despite the uncertainty surrounding our last few months of high school, thank you for our parents and teachers who have been patient and persistent, allowing us to complete our most strenuous task to date. We pray for the health and safety of everyone in attendance, as well as success in our future endeavors. Through your guidance, we hope to live purposeful lives, using what we've learned as well as our individual gifts to further your kingdom on earth. Amen. Please be seated. It's an honor to stand here this afternoon as the salutatorian of the graduating class of 2020. When we started our senior year, we never imagined that the circumstances out of our control would lead us to having a graduation ceremony that is unlike any other the school has performed. We are extremely grateful that we have still been afforded this opportunity. We are even more thankful that you have chosen to share in this momentous occasion with us. I would like to thank our principal, Ms. Melody Hanna, our vice principal, Ms. Beryl Knowles, Dr. Lyric Knowles, and all of our teachers for working tirelessly to make this ceremony a reality. To my classmates, although this is not what we imagined, this is still a celebration of what you were able to achieve. Enjoy this moment, you deserve it. To friends and family, both in attendance and watching via live stream, we thank you for sharing in this moment with us. The graduating class of 2020 says welcome.
Thank you, Tyler. I would like to invite our class of 2020 valedictorian, Ms. Jenna Knowles, to come and give her speech.
It was Eleanor Roosevelt who said, "If life were predictable, it would cease to be life and be without flavor." Madam Principal, Vice Principal, teachers, faculty, parents, and guests, a pleasant good afternoon. It is my pleasure to stand here on behalf of the amazing Genesis class of 2020. I want to begin by thanking all of you for being here to celebrate an occasion that we have been looking forward to since the start of senior year, if not the beginning of high school. I also have to thank all of our hardworking teachers for trying their best under the circumstances to continue to educate us for our upcoming examinations, as well as for all the work they have done for us over the years. I am also eternally grateful that Genesis Academy has a one-of-a-kind learning system that easily adjusted to the stay-at-home protocol and has greatly benefited me. I am that one student who grasps most subjects very quickly, but gets bored if I have to wait around for things to get done. With the blended program here at Genesis, I was able to fulfill my full potential, and I am forever thankful for the opportunities they have given me. My fellow graduates, it has been a rough year. And I'm talking even before God decided to shake things up and put Corona into the world. I remember back in November, genuinely questioning if I was gonna graduate this year. Then as the year went by, it progressively got worse because it was no longer just dealing with mounds of coursework and never-ending loads of work, but now we had to think about our futures. This meant we also had to prepare for college examinations, as well as applying for schools and working on scholarships. I remember the day when I felt like it was all coming together. I was so excited. It was the end of our final exams for the school year. Our last day was coming up. And from then on, it just felt like we were gonna wrap up some coursework, do the BGCSEs, and be finished. Sadly, that feeling of hope and excitement quickly faded when we were told that we had to stay home and be on lockdown. Of course, I'm sure we all enjoyed the fact that we could sleep in on some days, but learning from home just isn't the same. It required so much focus and strength in order to persevere. Personally, this makes me extremely proud when I think of the tremendous amount of hard work and perseverance that all of my classmates had to put in to make it here today. Honestly, I'm so incredibly excited that I'm graduating a year early. not only because it means getting high school over and done with, but because it gave me the opportunity to spend this year with the amazing people on stage. I truly feel like we got through this year together. There was always someone willing to help with an assignment, mostly me. Always someone to talk to, and most of all, there was never a dull moment, probably to the dismay of our teachers. We were always clowning around, telling jokes, or doing foolishness. Well, except me, I'm valedictorian, of course I didn't do that. Although this year has been hard on all of us, I can say that I enjoyed it, and it is definitely because of my classmates. This is why my wish for my fellow classmates tonight is that you will go on and bask in the same joy that you have brought to my life this year. We live now in unprecedented times. I mean, if a year ago somebody told me that the whole world would be locked down because of a virus, I wouldn't have believed it. This tragedy will remain in our memories for forever. I can't even begin to imagine what our futures are going to look like or what God will throw at all of us. But my hope for everyone is that you will make the best of all the finite moments we have on this earth. Because the one thing I believe this virus has taught all of us is that life is short and unpredictable. I truly hope that one day we can all look back on our lives, no matter what happens or how difficult it is, and say that we enjoyed it. Last but by no means least, I want to thank all of our parents for supporting us through this journey and for the sacrifices you have made in order to do so. I know it wasn't easy, especially because so many times we seemed ungrateful or grumbled while making what seemed to be insurmountable mistakes. But without your love and guidance, none of us could have made it here today. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the graduating class of 2020, I want to say thank you for defying the odds and being here to celebrate this momentous occasion with us. Thank you and good evening.
Next, I'm going to invite our principal, Mrs. Melody Trico-Hanna, and she is going to come with the principal's message. Please give her a round of applause.
Hello, everyone. Welcome. Let me begin by giving praise to the Almighty God for the great things He has done. We are not living in the best of times now, but God remains great. We are still battling COVID-19. Many are without jobs. Even though the economy is steadily opening, great uncertainty looms around the future and what will happen. Still, I place my trust in the Almighty God to bring us through these perilous times. As I look upon the high school class of 2020, you who came to cheer and our graduates on, as I look upon the dynamic teachers who stayed the course and performed their duties despite the COVID-19, I can attest that notwithstanding the times, Almighty God has been gracious and merciful to us. We must praise Him, for we are still here today. I congratulate the class of 2020 for the milestone you have achieved. It is important, for the foundation you have set will impact the rest of your life. As graduations go, yours will always be special because you have all served as witness to what I'm sure will register as one of the biggest crises in the 21st century. Take personal notes. For each of you are now fully qualified COVID-19 pandemic historians. 40 years from now, many of you will be grandparents. Perhaps one day you will be invited to address the class of 2060 on the great pandemic. You will not need to refer to the history books. You will simply say, "I was there." Now, I must say give special recognition to three members of this graduating class. Please stand when I call your name and remain standing until I am through with my comments to you. Adrian Coakley, Zane Moxie, and Leslie Smith. I singled you out because in the case of you, Adrian and Zane, both of you were here when our doors opened on Monday, September 4th, 2006. You were a part of the first fruits, the original 14 students of Genesis Academy. Leslie, you came only a few weeks later, and tonight you represent the first students to pass through our entire system from kindergarten through high school. You not only have a special place in Genesis' history, but in my heart, and especially Mrs. Beryl Knowles, because you three were her very first three kindergarten students. You were among the first students over which we had the oversight as principals. So I salute you tonight for the privilege of serving as your principal. I also wish to ask Nathan Stewart to stand, who arrived 2 years later, but also spent his entire kindergarten through high school years with us. Now you may wonder, how could that be? Well, Nathan was in a hurry, so he skipped ahead. To the remainder of the class, I am so grateful for the contribution each of you have added to the tapestry that is Genesis and making it the great place that it is. So just to make sure you are equally appreciated, I am going to shout just a few characteristics, and if it identifies you, just yell out, "Das me." Talented. Gifted, uniquely creative, stimulating, razor sharp, well behaved. I also extend hearty congratulations to you, our parents, for the stellar job in partnering with us. The pandemic has significantly raised the appreciation for the teaching profession. So I ask all parents of Genesis Academy to please stand and show by applause your appreciation for the effort made by our teachers. Thank you, parents. You may be seated. I also wish to recognize the outstanding job of our custodians who keep our campus so clean and sanitized. And I am so proud of the exceptional job of our business office manager under the keen leadership of Giorgio Knowles, assisted by Miss Imana Fonseca. You may be seated, boys. Every year, I presented the principal's message in a video summary. Unfortunately, with time constraints imposed upon us by the pandemic, we cannot deliver our usual video presentation. However, I will be sure to provide the video summary in the fall. To you graduates, you are leaving school for the first time, and some may be leaving home for the first time. It is important to remember as you leave that life is a journey. And on that journey, there are highways and trials and pathways. Journeys lead to great and exciting places, but more often than not, they lead to dead ends, littered with broken hearts and lost dreams. I pray more than anything else that your Genesis education will keep you on the road to peace. I pray that while you were here, you received the right roadmap, a proper calibrated GPS, because only then can you be certain that you have the right navigational tools. If you have not yet done so, set your course. Choose well, because there is a way that seems right to a person, but its end is destruction. I pray that on your journey, you will choose life. Jesus said, That's why I came, so that you may have that, so that you may not only have life, but life abundantly. I can't tell you how long your journey will be. That is determined by God alone. But I can tell you with certainty, your journey will be strenuous. So travel light. Drop all the things that weigh you down and add stress to the journey. Drop the bad attitudes, negative self-images, selfish ambitions, and all the things that might lead to the diminishing of your character, integrity, and reputation. I will continue to pray for you, and I need you more than ever to pray for me now. Adrian, Zane, and Leslie, when you arrived at Genesis, I was 45 years old. Now, Mr. and Dr. Moxie, I hope that that helps to put things into perspective for you. My dear students, I know it doesn't appear so, but I just turned 60 in January of this year. So I really need your prayers. I also need you to remember Genesis. Please speak well of us. We look forward to you coming back, helping us grow and investing in us to be a continuing part of this great legacy. So as you set upon your journey, make us proud and depart yourself like a person from a place where great minds begin.
That awesome speech. Thank you, students, for your honesty. Okay, now on to our trophy ceremony. Please note that students will be called in alphabetical order, with the exception of the salutatorian and the valedictorian. Class of 2020, are you ready? Can I please invite the back row to stand? First, we have Miss Madison Archer. Madison is receiving the Class of 2020 Trophy, Photography, and the BGCSE Art Award. She is attaining certificates in Religious Education, Microsoft Office, Videography, Art and Design, Physical Education. Madison was accepted to Nova Scotia Community College, and she plans to attend there in the fall, and currently her degree is undecided. Let's hear it from Madison Archer. Can I invite Madison's parents to come to the front for the photo, please? Coming up next, we have Miss Sierra Cartwright. Sierra is receiving the Class of 2020 Trophy and the Christian Character Female Award. She's receiving certificates in math, English, religious education, world geography, biology, history, videography, and physical education. She was accepted to Pensacola Christian College and Trinity College in Florida, and she plans to attend Pensacola Christian College to study elementary education and then obtain a master's in occupational therapy. Let's congratulate Miss Sierra Cartwright. Coming up next, we have Mr. Adrian Coakley. Adrian is receiving the Class of 2020 Trophy, the Legacy Award, and Most Outstanding in Microsoft Applications. He's receiving certificates in Microsoft Office, Videography, Commerce, Physical Education. Adrian has been accepted to Seneca University, and he plans to study Business Technology Management at Seneca University in the fall, and then work in Canada, and eventually return home to work at the family business Infinite Power. Give it up for Adrian Coakley. Can I invite Adrian's parents to meet him at the front? Coming up next, we have Miss Indica Gibson. Indica is receiving trophies in the Class of 2020, the Alpha House Captain Female and Nursing Cadet. She's receiving certificates for Honor Roll, English, Religious Education, Microsoft Office, Biology, Commerce, Videography, Physical Education, and College Planner. Indica was accepted to the University of the Bahamas, and she plans to study pediatric nursing. Let's give it up for Indica Gibson. Indica's parents, you can please come to the bottom of the stage for your photos. Coming up next, we have Miss Savvy Isaacs. Savvy is receiving the Class of 2020 trophy, Most Improved Overall, Most Outstanding Drama, Nursing Cadet, Most Outstanding Physical Education, Female, Most Outstanding Math, and she's receiving certificates for Honorable Mention, Mathematics, Religious Education, Drama, Art and Design, and Biology. Savvy was accepted to the University of the Bahamas, and she plans to pursue a bachelor's degree in biochemistry and a master's in cosmetology. Give Savvy a round of applause. Can I have Savvy's parents please join us to the front? Coming up next, we have Miss Jade Kerr. Jade is receiving the Class of 2020 trophy and certificates in mathematics, religious education, and world geography. Jade has been accepted to Middle Tennessee State University, and she plans to attend there in the fall to study either psychology or computer science. Let's give Jade a round of applause. Can Jade's parents please make their way to the front for a photo? Coming up next, we have Miss Gwendolyn Lightborn. Gwendolyn is receiving trophies, the Class of 2020 trophy, Most Outstanding Combined Science. She's receiving certificates for Honor Roll, English, Religious Education, Microsoft Office, World Geography, Biology, Combined Science, Physical Education, and College Planner. Gwen was accepted to the University of the Bahamas, and she plans to study biology and eventually become a domestic and exotic animal veterinarian. Let's give Gwendolyn Lightborn a round of applause. And I'm just going to invite Gwendolyn's parents to make their way to the front, please. Coming up next, we have Mr. Zane Moxie. Zane is receiving the Class of 2020 Trophy, the Legacy Award, Christian Character Male, and tied for Most Outstanding Technical Drawing. He's receiving certificates for Honorable Mention, English, Religious Knowledge, Art and Design, Technical Drawing, Combined Science, Physical Education, and College Planner. Zane has been accepted to the University of the Bahamas, Wichita State University, and Montserrat College of Art. He plans to attend Wichita State University in the fall to study entrepreneurship and innovation. Let's give Zane Moxie a round of applause. Okay, next I would like to invite front row, please stand. Back row, you may be seated. Next I would like to invite Mr. Ethan Pinder. Ethan is receiving the Class of 2020 Trophy and the Trophy for Most Outstanding Art. He's receiving certificates in Religious Education, Microsoft Office, Art and Design, and Physical Education. He was accepted to the University of the Bahamas, and he plans to study information technology. Let's give Ethan a round of applause. Can I have Ethan's parents please make their way to the front for a photo? Coming up next, we have class president, Miss Chase Ramsey. Chase is receiving the Class of 2020 Trophy, School Spirit, Leadership, Omega Team Captain Female, Certificates in Religious Education, BGCSE, English, BGCSE, Drama, World Geography, Videography, Physical Education, and College Planner. Chase has been accepted to Nova Southeastern University, and she plans to study exercise and sports science. Let's give Chase Ramsey a round of applause. Mr. and Mrs. Ramsey, can you please make your way to the front? Coming up next, we have Mr. Taro Sears. Taro is receiving trophies for the Class of 2020, the Alpha Team Captain, Boys, Extracurricular Recognition in Swimming, Certificates in Mathematics, Religious Knowledge, Microsoft Office, Videography, Physical Education. Taro is accepted to the University of the Bahamas, and he plans to study marine biology. Let's give Taro a round of applause. Can I please have Taro's parents come to the front? Coming up next, we have Leslie Smith. Leslie is receiving trophies for the Class of 2020 Legacy Award, Fine Arts in Music, School Spirit, Citizenship, Certificates in Religious Knowledge, Drama, and Physical Education. Leslie has been accepted to Bethune-Cookman University, where he achieved a band scholarship, Oral Roberts University, the University of Bridgeport, and the University of the Bahamas. He plans to attend the University of the Bahamas to study a bachelor's degree in music and eventually join the Royal Bahamas Police Force. Let's give Leslie a round of applause. Can I have Leslie's parents? May I have Leslie's parents meet us to the bottom of the stage? Next, we have
Mr. Nathan Stewart. Nathan is receiving trophies for the class of 2020 and tied for most outstanding in history. Certificates in religious education, technical drawing, history, physical education. Nathan has been accepted to the University of the Bahamas and he plans to study engineering to become a city planner. Let's give Nathan a round of applause. May I have Nathan's parents please come to the bottom of the stage? Coming up next, we have Mr. Zion Williamson. Zion has earned trophies for the class of 2020, most outstanding physical education male, and tied for most outstanding technical drawing. He's been accepted to Northern Southeastern University and the University of the Bahamas. He plans to study child psychology and philosophy. Let's give Zion a round of applause. May I have Zion's parents join us, please? Now we have the class of 2020 salutatorian. Let's welcome Mr. Tyler Williams. Tyler has earned the class of 2020 trophy, most outstanding BGCSE English, most outstanding English, tied most outstanding history, Omega House co-captain male, most outstanding BGCSE math, certificates in drama, physical education, college planner in history, accepted to Johnson & Wales University, Nova Southeastern University, University of the Bahamas. He plans to attend the University of the Bahamas in the fall, and his major is undecided. Let's give Tyler a round of applause. May I please have Tyler's parents join us for a photo? And now for our valedictorian. We have Miss Jenna Knowles. Jenna is achieving trophies for the class of 2020, most outstanding chemistry, most outstanding biology, most outstanding commerce, most outstanding Spanish, most outstanding religious education, certificates for honor roll, religious education, Microsoft Office, Spanish, biology, chemistry, commerce, physical education, and college planner. She's been accepted to the University of the Bahamas and Youngstown State University. She plans to become a crime lab analyst in the forensic science field. Let's give Jenna Knowles a round of applause. May I have Jenna's parents join us to the front, please? Before I have the graduates switch their tassels over, there is one special award that we give each year, and the name of the award is the Herbert Trico Humility, Kindness, and Service Award. And this award is given to the student who displays these qualities. This year, receiving the Herbert Trico Humility, Kindness, and Service Award is Mr. Zane Moxie.
concludes the awards presentation for this evening, but we're not quite done yet, almost. But I would just like to personally congratulate the class of 2020, and I'm trying to say this without crying, because most of them I have taught as well, and I'm not going to give my age like Mrs. Hanna did, but most of them I have taught from the third grade up, and so they have become an intricate part of my life, and the ones who have joined later, it's like they were always there. I feel like these are my kids, and I thank you for the opportunity to have been your teacher, and I hope that even in the times that I had to row, that you feel my deep love and admiration for all of you. You are all uniquely and wonderfully made, and you each have added color to my life and memories that I will never forget. Congratulations. I would like to invite Pastor Henry Francis. He's the grandfather of one of our graduates, Nathan Stewart, to pray for the graduates. Pastor Hanna said this was also his Sunday school teacher.
I was hoping he didn't open that door. He made me work. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you thanks for all these graduates, for what they've achieved over the years here in school and in their lifetime already. We pray for their protection in the years ahead. I thank you, dear Lord, for the dedication of their parents and their family members, especially during this time when things were difficult to seemingly almost impossible. I thank you, too, for the dedication of the administration and the staff of Genesis. I pray that your wisdom would prevail in the decisions that are made in the school and by the students in the years to come. Thank you, dear God, for protecting our country. Thank you for protecting these graduates. And thank you, dear God, for life itself. My prayer above all is that in their lifetime, and before too long, they would make that big choice, the number one choice that they could make in their lifetime, by accepting Jesus as Lord and allowing him to direct their lives throughout the years. Once again, dear God, we thank you for life itself and all that you've given us. Let your name be blessed. In Jesus' name, amen.
William. Now I'm going to ask the class of 2020 to stand. You may now switch your tassels. Let's congratulate Genesis Academy class of 2020. Give them a round of applause. Now, parents, as you know, we've planned a vehicular salute.
Take one.